Fish oil is one of the most popular health supplements right now, but there's a lot of conflicting information out there whether it works. What does it really do? Does it help Alzheimer's? Does it help pregnancy? Does it help your heart? Dr. Alan Magaziner is here now talking about fish oil, and is it really right for you? Thanks for being here.
Sure, it's my pleasure.
So what does it do for us? Is it good or bad?
Fish oil overall is good. I really feel it's one of the most important nutrients we could take. What it does, it helps to reduce inflammation in our body. And so many of the chronic illnesses we see today are linked to inflammation. Heart disease, high blood pressure, high cholesterol, triglycerides, Alzheimer's disease, in fact. Also, even during pregnancy, it's important that women take some fish oil because it helps with brain development in the undeveloped fetus.
I admit that I take fish oil, but I also take it because I have dry eyes, and it works for dry eye syndrome.
Very important. Excellent. There's a study that just came out that showed that taking fish oils over 90 days was actually more effective than the placebo. And in fact, it increased the tear production and tear volume. So it's one of the newer factors that may help to increase the tears.
Key here is don't just get any fish oil. You got to be careful.
Right. Absolutely. I mean, some fish oils out there can turn rancid relatively rapidly. Some don't have the adequate vitamin C to protect that from happening. You need a very good quality fish oil, and keep it in the refrigerator when you store it at home, and also take it with some food. If you don't take it with food, sometimes you'll feel a little upset stomach. You might get a little burping.
You don't want that burping sensation. I've tried that before, just the liquid into the shake. It's better to put it in the pills. All right, there's another topic I want to talk about. This is in the Journal of the American Medical Association. It links those sugared drinks, you know, or orange juice even, to gout. Can you explain to everybody what gout is and the connection here?
Well, gout occurs when there's an increase or an excess of uric acid production in the body, and what happens, it causes inflammation. Once again, we get back to the inflammation. But what it does, it causes a lot of pain and inflammation, typically in the joints and commonly in the feet.
That's arthritis or?
Yeah, it's a gouty arthritis, basically. But it's due to a specific dietary factor, and that is the high gout factors. And sometimes animal proteins, in fact, something like animal organ meats, I should say, kidney and liver are high in uric acid. It increases the uric acid, and then we see it turn into an inflammatory process.
So it's the acid in these sugary drinks and the orange juice, not necessarily the sugar?
Well, no.
The acid?
This new study actually says that it's the fructose-sweetened drinks now, which are sodas, in fact. People are drinking 3 and 4 of these a day, and they're loaded with this fructose now. And some of the high fructose corn syrup drinks now also may be a trouble for us, too. So we're seeing that these drinks may increase uric acid and therefore increasing risk of gout. And in particular, the study was done in women, but we've seen other studies previously done in men as well.
All right. Well, Dr. Alan Magaziner, thanks so much for joining us. I'm hoping we can take a shot of John Bolaris.